day, everyone. In this video, we will discuss ratio and proportion. In this video, we will define and illustrate ratio and proportion, and we will enumerate properties of proportion. What is the first thing that comes into your mind when we say ratio? So, when we say ratio, it is a comparison between two numbers or quantities with the same units. Ito yung kino-compare natin yung dalawang numbers or dalawang category or quantities. Let's say I have triangles and square. So, how are we going to write the ratios of triangles to square? So you can see I have two triangles and three squares. And remember, in writing the ratio, it can be expressed in four ways and can be written as colon form, division form, phrase form, or yung tinatawag nilang word form, and a fraction form. We have four ways in writing the comparison of two numbers or quantity or yung tinatawag nating ratio. And all of this comparison read as 2 is to 3. Again, 2 is to 3. Now, let's have an example. Express the following ratios in simplest form. Dito, hinihingi yung simplified form or simplified ratio ng bawat given. Now, let's have number 1. So, 1 hour to 40 minutes. Hindi natin pwedeng ilagay na 1 over 40 or 1 is to 40. Hindi po pwede dahil ang isang number ay hour at ang isang given natin ay minute. Remember, dapat pareho po sila ng unit. So, ano ba ang equivalent ng 1 hour sa minutes? This is 60 minutes, right? So, for us to get simplest form, i-divide natin both numerators and denominators sa kanyang GCF or greatest common factor. So, we have 20.
A proportion is an equation that shows two ratios are equal.
How do we write a proportion? It can be written as A is to B equal C is to D, or A over B equal C over D. As you can see, pwedeng naka-colon form at pwedeng naka-fraction form. You may read this as A is to B equal to C is to D. Again, A is to B and C is to D. Remember, your B should not be equal to 0 and your D should not be equal to 0 too. So, let's have an example. So, let us give the ratio of triangles to squares. So, let us count. 1, 2. So, 2 is 3. And this one, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 triangles. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, 6 squared. So, 4:6. Now, paano natin ipapakita ang proportion dito? So, if these two ratios are equal, then we can call it proportion. Again, if these two ratios are equal, then we can call it proportion. To check if these two ratios are equal, ganito ang gagawin natin. So, ang quantities of each quantity, yung A, B, C, at D, ito po yung tinatawag nating terms. A ang 2, B ang 3, at ang C ay 4, at ang D naman natin ay 6. Ayun pong tinatawag nating terms. So, ang tawag naman po sa B, at ang value ng B ay 3, at C ang 4, ay means. Si 3 at 4 are the means. While ang A at ang ating D, ang tinatawag namang extremes. So, ang 2 at 6 ang ating extremes. Ito na po yung parts ng ating proportion. So, these are your terms, 2, 3, 4, and 6. And these are your means, yung B and C. Or yung 3 at yung 4. And these are your extremes, A and D, or yung 2 at yung 6. To check if these two ratios are equal, ganito ang gagawin natin. Multiply the means, 3 times 4 is equal to 12. And then, 2 times 6, the extremes. It is also equal to 12. So, as you can see, the product of the means is equal to the product of the extremes. Or you can also use a cross multiplication. I-multiply mo si 2 at 6, it is equal to 12. And yung means, this is also 12. So, the product of the extremes is equal to the product of your means. So, the product of the extreme is equal to the product of the means. That is A times D equal to B times C. Let's have another way. So, what is the another way of identifying whether your ratios are equal or if they are proportion? So, if two ratios can be simplified into the same ratio, ito po yung tinatawag nating lowest term. So, kapag yung dalawang ratio mo ay simplify mo, then pareho sila ng lowest term, then the ratio are equal and the proportion is true. Let's talk about the properties of proportion. We have cross multiplication, alternation property, inverse property, addition property, subtraction property, and the sum property of the original proportion. Paano kapag may missing value? Ito na naman yung kailangan nating hanapin, yung x. So, we can solve the missing value in proportion by cross multiplication property. Thank you. Again, we are from Grade 9 Akasha. And if you like to get updated in the next video, please do like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more upcoming videos.